Lake Street down. Hope that it's really well out. It's a blessing to be here, and a blessing to have His presence with us in beautiful things. It really matters what we meditate on. Can you turn me down just a little bit? It really matters what we meditate on. And what does meditate mean? You run into meditate a lot in the scriptures. It tells us to meditate on a lot of things, right? Meditate on His word. Meditate on wonderful things He has done. It also tells us some stuff to not meditate on. It talks about imaginations that are evil. But it's really just, what are you thinking about? What are you remembering? What are you worrying about? What are you hoping for? What are you imagining? What are you dreaming? Really, the things that go over and over in your mind, that you're pondering and thinking about over, that's really meditating. And we don't really realize, I think, a lot of times, that we are inadvertently meditating on negative stuff. We don't think of it as that. We don't think about it at all. It's just randomly comes kind of naturally and automatically to our minds. But we can easily have a habit of dwelling on bad things that have happened, or things that we're afraid might happen, or mistakes we have made, instead of thinking about the blessings of who God is, what He has said about us, what He has said to us, yes. What He has done for us,
yes.
How He has answered prayers, how He has worked. He talks about meditating on his creation. I mean, that's an awesome thing, thinking about His creation. But in the course of the day, how often are we thinking about that? How often are we thinking about how big God is, how great He is, how marvelous He is, how merciful He has been to us.
Yes.
So I don't think that we have a habit of thinking that way. But if we can develop a habit of thinking that way, it will bless us.
Amen.
It will bless the people around
us. Lord.
It will change our relationship with God.
Yes.
Because it's the way we relate.
Amen.
We relate to Him, ourselves,
yes.
Our lives,
yes.
And other people out of those things that are going on in our head.
Amen.
And I don't know about you, but a lot of negative junk just real easy plays in my head.
Yes.
Really.
Yes.
And I didn't learn not to be like that. But when I look at the word, it tells us, right? God wants to sanctify our imaginations too.
Mm-hmm, yes.
Right? He gave you an imagination.
Mm-hmm.
And you're supposed to use it.
Yes.
But the enemy wants to play on it and take the imagination, oh, it's got you and whatever, you all crippled up
mm-hmm.
or something, right? And your imagination is some kind of negative junk.
Yes.
The world's coming, the sky's falling, right?
Yes.
And we imagine those things.
Mm-hmm.
And we use up our energy on that.
We do.
And our faith goes down.
Yes, yes.
And our energy goes down.
Yes.
And we become worn and thin on the inside of our soul.
Yes.
But if we will train ourselves
mm-hmm.
to practice thinking about the things He has already proven about Himself. Okay, He has revealed Himself to be all-powerful, merciful, full of compassion, the Almighty God, right? He has revealed that. He has proven that. And when Jesus walked the earth, He was revealing the heart of the Father. Look at who He was. Look at how He interacted with people. Look at the love and the power that was in that, you know, and so that's who He is. And if we can start to practice just a little bit,
amen,
taking our minds to meditating, thinking on those good things.
My God.
Think about, remember something where God came through.
Yes.
And you knew it was Him.
Yes.
Think about things that He has said that you know is good.
Yes.
And it's a blessing. If we will just start doing that, we will find our faith grows stronger,
yes.
And God will do more among us.
Yes.
You know, as a people,
amen.
This church and this community, we've been through it.
Yes.
We've been through a whole lot of mess. And that can condition the way we think and what we imagine about the future. Okay, but God's word's got something else to say, right? And so did he not say to us last week not to despise the day of the small beginnings?
Yep.
God is doing new things.
Oh my God.
Stuff is starting to come together. God is lining up things, and God is going to do stuff through us and reach people in this community.
Oh my God.
But we got to start believing in that and imagining that, and don't think of things as how they've been, as it says in Isaiah. Don't remember the former things. Do not remember the past. Behold, I will do something new.
Amen.
And God is going to do something new in your personal lives. Okay, that's better than what the devil is telling you.
Yeah.
Okay, and he's going to do something with this body of believers that's better than what the devil is telling you.
Amen.
So it really matters what we meditate on.
I